Hey guys, Pundiful World of Disney here. Happy Halloween. We are bringing to you our reaction of the recently released Hocus Pocus 2 on Disney Plus. We're going to tell you what we thought of it, if we enjoyed it or not, the scenes we enjoyed. What'd you think?
I guess let's get started, right? What's the first thing we want to talk about? Just our initial reaction to it? Did we like it?
I loved it.
I thought it was cute.
I definitely enjoyed it. I thought it was a little more comedic than the first one, but not overly. I thought it was appropriate. I thought it was good for the times that we're in. More modern jokes.
Yes, I liked it. I thought it was funny. I like that they gave a backstory in the beginning to the witches.
Yes, the little ones played it well.
Yes. Yeah, I thought they were casted very well
too. They were.
Yeah. I thought right from the very start, I was like, wow, these kids, their mannerisms, their like speech inflections, they were so, so spot on. I was like, wow, those kids are amazing. I wanted more story with them.
They were so good. The assignment. I also loved Tony Hale as the Reverend. Like, I'm a fan of him from watching Veep. And at first I didn't realize that was him. And then like, I had such like a revelation, like, oh my God, that's Gary.
We like him from Arrested Development and a series of Unfortunate Events. So yeah, it's good to see more. Which one?
A Series of Unfortunate Events. Yes. You know what? I didn't finish that show, so maybe I like stopped watching before.
And, season 2 or 3, he was in the in crowd.
Okay.
But he was fun. And then I liking a little backstory of Billy Butcherson.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, a little bit with him.
Yeah. I thought it was interesting that like you could have gotten by without watching the first movie because I don't know why you would, but they called back enough to it, like explaining where it was relevant and like how it connected, but it was its own story, really.
They threw in some scenes from the original to kind of show what they were talking about, which was good.
Would
we think of the new girls, like the little trio that only became a trio really towards the end, but
they meshed well. I think I liked that it was giving three girls that I really know if they're in anything else a shot at a Disney movie, which was good.
Yeah, they were good. They were good. I was saying in the beginning, I think I would have liked, like you said, a little bit more backstory with the witches. Like, where was their mom? They said something about their dad, but there was no mention of their mom. Like, what? And I thought, what if she was six? How old was she? 16?
16.
I'm like, I thought these girls were like 12. They looked way
but
young.
It was nice to not see like a 26-year-old playing a 16-year-old.
Right. They might very well have been 16.
Yeah, I don't know. I think we're just to assume they were like left alone, like orphans. They just had each other.
Very good. Yeah, I like the they had the same mannerisms as their adult forms with the
crooked smiles. It was so good.
Yeah.
And the teeth.
Yes.
Did anyone else like want to like slightly tear up when like the actual Sanderson sisters like arrived for the first time on the screen? Because I did.
I liked it, but then I feel like they went into song for no reason.
Yeah, that felt a little out of place. I was like, what is happening here?
Listen, they were excited, okay? Sometimes you just have to start singing.
Break out in song.
I actually thought, I was like, Lisa might hate this because all of a sudden it's a musical.
They kept it short, though.
Mm-hmm.
Would we think of the other musical number, one way or another?
That was good. I like that song.
I mean, there was no I Put a Spell on You, but...
No,
it wasn't that. But I liked the little flash mob that they went into.
Yes.
Did you guys notice the little homage to like past costumes from the first one?
Yes.
The
Supreme. Mayor.
Right. The mayor was in on the line in the
candy apple.
The devil and the housewife costume were right behind it. Mm-hmm. And then in the flash mob, I saw someone dressed as Madonna, or the mom dressed as Madonna.
Yeah.
Good little nod to the original.
Yes. Yeah. I liked when they then, after, it was kind of after that scene and they passed that house and the two people are watching, like, the first Hocus Pocus.
Yes.
I thought there was a lot of cute little clever, like, Easter eggs for the first one. I thought
It was very, like, Scream. Like, you mm-hmm. know, the newest Scream, like, is very, like, self-referential to, like, mm-hmm. making fun of themselves. And there was a lot of moments like that.
Was this a good sequel? Does it stand up to the first? Was it forced? What do you guys think?
It doesn't stand up to the first. Like, without the first, I don't think anyone would care about this movie. Do you know what I mean?
Right.
Correct.
I will say, like, I see some people talking about, like, how they're disappointed in it and stuff, or, like, it's nowhere near as good as the first. But, like, I think anyone would be, like, delusional to have expected that this is going to be anywhere near the first one. Like, I'm sorry, that's like, it's like a 30-year-old cult classic. Like, you're setting yourself up for, like, failure and disappointment if you thought this was going to be, like, exactly on par with that movie. So we're also lucky just to have gotten this at all.
Yeah.
Right. So, like, I think you just have to appreciate it for what it was. Like, it was a fun, campy, DCOM style movie, like, with characters that we love so much. And thankfully they were played by the original cast. And like, it was a fun time.
They looked amazing. They looked amazing.
And that's another thing. Anyone saying, oh, they look so old. It's like, I'm sorry, do you look the same way you looked 30 years ago? Like,
obviously
they look older.
Sarah Jessica Parker went from 27 to 57.
What? Yeah, there's a big difference.
Yeah.
Yes, Bette Midler didn't change.
No, and Kathy and Jimmy looked better, I thought.
Yeah. I know.
Yeah, I think for what it was great. You know, you didn't go in thinking, like, this is going to be better than the first. You went thinking, like, all right, it's going to be cute. It'll be a good time. Were some parts cringy? Yeah, but it
all
was
Disney, supposed all to Disney be. All Disney channel movies
are. Yeah.
You just go and enjoy it for what it is. I think in that sense, yeah, it was great.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
What was your guys' favorite scene?
I have to say the entire Walgreens set.
Yes! I was thinking that too. One. Yeah. Yes! Drinking the, like, lotions and stuff.
The balls are put in already.
Yeah. And, like, the fluorescence. Oh, I knew her.
I know.
Yeah.
My favorite line.
Kathy holds up the sheet mask.
That's a charming name for a child.
Yeah. When they were eating the sheet mask. That was killing me.
The child.
Yeah.
I like when they're in the salt circle. And then the rumors come. Yeah. It's like, they're going to help them. They hate messes.
Yeah, I know, that was clever too.
Yeah, everything in Walgreens, I think.
They had some great lines. I thought, oh, and when they're talking to Alexa in the house.
There's a little woman trapped inside this box.
Yeah. That was kind of reminiscent though of, like, them being put into the oven and they're hearing, like, the radio saying, like, I'm looking for a children's book, like, bonjour.
Yeah.
That was like the modern day version of that.
Mm-hmm.
Right. So that was fun. All those scenes were great.
Mm-hmm.
I actually would love if they ever made, like, a little series of, like, shorts of the Sandersons just, like, experiencing such regular, common, everyday
modern
things.
Stuff. Yeah. Yeah.
Like, that was so good. I would want more stuff like Walgreens.
Right.
Like the shorts they had with Forky on Disney Plus, but make it like the
Sandersons. Never watched, but probably something like that.
Yeah. You're not missing much.
No.
I wanted more backstory on those kids playing the sisters, and I wanted more, like, Walgreens.
Yeah.
The whole movie could have been that, and I would have been like, okay, great. I don't need a plot. No plot necessary.
So do you think they're going to make a third one after the end credits scene?
No.
I think they left it open.
They should.
Based on reaction to this, like, to see how well it's received. And, you know, if they want to cash in again, they will.
I can see
that. I don't think it's necessary.
I can see a sequel, maybe with the same girls, like a series, maybe.
Right. They set it up that they wouldn't need those three, though.
No, this is the
way
they're
not going to get those three again.
You see the three younger girls walking at the end in the
Yeah. No, I'm talking about, like, the Sanderson sisters. They set it up so that if there is anything else, they don't need them in it because there's no shot they're getting the three of those, the three of them again.
But there is another Black Flame candle.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know.
That little witch bird. The witch showed up at the end before the credits.
Yes, she did. Mm-hmm. She's still around.
Say what you were thinking.
I was thinking before. I don't know if this was supposed to be inferred, but the main witch in the beginning says, "Don't use that magic of Maximus spell." And then they notice that she has no coven. I'm wondering if she made the same mistake as Winifred.
If she used it.
I thought of that too. But then when I rewatched the movie again today, and it was that whole opening scene again, she did say it was like basically due to like how the people of Salem treated witches. Mm-hmm. So like, you know, witches were burned and stuff like that. So I think they were just killed.
Mm-hmm. That too.
But I thought of that too at the end, like when I saw the end and like her sisters were disappearing, I was like, oh, maybe that's what happened to that mother witch. But then when I rewatched,
I thought in this one it seemed like we were gonna learn a lot more about the book and like the origins and like, is it a person in the book? They just seem to like give it much more of a personality
with emotion, like they show it crying, yeah, like
sweating,
yeah,
when it was nervous.
Yeah.
Like, what's going on with the book? I kind of felt like, not a plot hole, but I was like, are they telling me more about the book? I want to learn more.
And that's when the series will come out.
Mm.
So we, overall, I think we enjoyed it, yes?
Yes.
Good.
I'm happy with it.
I think we're happy they did it, and I think it was...
We'll probably watch it a couple more times.
It was for the fans.
It was fan service, for sure.
Yeah. Watching it, if you didn't love the first one, you know, like that's, you did it for nostalgia, like people like us watched it and told their kids, sit down, watch this, you know.
Stay quiet.
Yeah,
our kids enjoyed it,
they liked it, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and they love
of course
the first
they
one.
Would
yeah
they love the first one. it was good.
So wrap it up, I think overall,
yeah, thumbs up. Three broomsticks.
it has rewatchability. We can all watch it again.
Absolutely.
Yes,
definitely.
It's
quotable.
Yes. Yeah, I want more quotes. That's what I'll have to gather when I watch it again. More quotes. Mostly Mary's, I think. Mary had the best quotes.
Yeah. I just loved like Mary laughing at herself constantly. Like she'll say something and then just like gasp. Like I just love her.
Winnie, come here. I know it was the favorite. You don't have to tell her. At the end of the movie when they're disappearing.
Oh, yeah, that she's the favorite.
Yeah.
They had the same goodbyes as the first movie, too.
Yeah, yeah.
Just the bye-bye and Sarah, the goodbye.
All right, guys. I hope you also enjoyed Hocus Pocus 2.
Let us know what you think, what your reactions to it were.
Yes, let us know if you liked it like us. If not, tell us why not. And enjoy your Halloween season, your spooky season. Give us a like and a subscribe if you enjoyed watching this. And have a wonderful Halloween, guys.
Bye.
Bye-bye.